நமன் கணாதிபம் குஹம் விநாயகம் குரும் ஸ்மரன் சுரம் சுசாந்த தேஹினம் த்ரிலோகபாஸ்வரீம் த்ரிகாலதர்ஷிகாம் நமாமி தாம்பராம் ப்ரதஸ்வரூபிகாம். ஞானினாமபி சேதாம்சி தேவி பகவதி ஹி சா பலாதாக்ருஷ்ய மோஹாய மகாமாயா பிரயச்சதி. She takes hold of the minds of the best of scholars, most intelligent, and sinks them in ignorance, moha, false knowledge and beliefs. Jnaninamapi, even the minds of jnanis. We presume that someone has become a jnani when he has realized what is real and unreal in this world. Only when someone has got this knowledge and seems to be steadily established in this knowledge and conducts himself accordingly, we say that, oh, he is a jnani. But even their minds are open to influence by her. In a matter of seconds, she can throw them back into ignorance, into thought and behavior just like that of an ordinary human being. Fears, anxieties, desires, anger, greed, everything can come back to them. That is her power. It is not only that she is capable of this, she does that very often. I think we should look into the scandals that have come out in the recent past connected to spiritual gurus from this perspective also. Have they always been like this? We don't know. But it is quite possible that this aspect of Mahamaya has worked on them. Realized beings apparently spreading knowledge. Suddenly something happens, they fall. Jnaninam abhichetamsi தேவி பகவதி ஹி சா பலாத் ஆக்ருஷ்ய மோஹாய மகாமாயா பிரயச்சதி. வாட் இஸ் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் தேவி? தீவ்யதி இதி தேவி. திஸ் இஸ் ஹர் பிளே. திஸ் இஸ் ஹவு ஷீ அம்யூசஸ் ஹர் செல்ஃப். திஸ் இஸ் ஹவு ஷீ என்ஜாய்ஸ். திஸ் இஸ் வாட் ஷீ என்ஜாய்ஸ். தீப்யமானா தேவி. அண்ட் ஆல்சோ சென்ஸ் ஷீ ஷைன்ஸ். ஷீ ஹேஸ் பிரில்லியன்ஸ். ஷீ ஹேஸ் அ பிரில்லியன்ட் க்ளோ ஆல் அரவுண்ட் ஹர். பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தேட் ஆல்சோ ஷீ இஸ் கால்ட் தேவி. What is the meaning of Bhagavati? Bhagamasti yasyaha sa Bhagavati. She has Bhaga, hence she is called Bhagavati. What is Bhaga? Aishwaryasya samagrasya viryasya yashasa shriyaha jnana vairagyayoschaiva shannam Bhaga idirana. Bhaga has 6 components. All kinds of aishwarya or powers. Courage or valor. Fame. ஸ்ரீ ஆர் வெல்த். நாலெஜ் அண்ட் வைராக்யா. டிட்டாச்மெண்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஆல் தி அதர் 5. சம்மன் ஹூ பொசஸஸ் ஆல் தி 6 இஸ் கால்ட் பகவான் ஆர் பகவதி. தயா விசர்ஜதே விஸ்வம் ஜகதே தச்சராச்சரம் சைஷா பிரசன்னா வரதா நிருணாம் பவதி முக்தயே சாவித்யா பரமா முக்தேர் ஹேது பூதா சநாதனி சம்சாரபந்த ஹேதுஷ்ச சைவ சர்வேஸ்வரேஸ்வரி. She only creates this universe which has moving and non-moving beings. தயா விசர்ஜதே விஸ்வம். The universe is a perception. Certain stimulations reach your sensory organs. They work on your brain through your nervous system and certain images, sounds, etc. are thrown up in your mind. It is like a movie. A play of lights and sound that make you feel that something is happening in front of you. Now we have a better analogy, virtual reality. You don't need a real world to perceive a real world. A few electronic signals are sufficient. That's how virtual reality devices work. These signals can get into your brain and create the feeling of a world that doesn't exist for real. They are just a few machine-generated signals and you get the same feeling that the virtual world, the virtual reality is there for real. This is what Sarveshwari Mahamaya also does in a much more advanced way. She only has to create those signals. They will get into your brain or mind or whatever you prefer to call it through your sensory organs and create this virtual reality. The world that you think exists for real today. The universe that you think exists for real today. If you understand this, you will realize that the universe is just a few signals, a few vibrations which are reaching your brain through your sensory organs and creating a virtual reality, just like the virtual reality device that we have today in a much more complex manner. This is a universe experience. And who creates this illusion? Who creates those signals that creates this illusion in your mind that a world exists outside you for real? That's her, Mahamaya, Bhagavati. Taya visarjyate vishwam. Everything that you think that exists around you, movable, immovable. Jagadeda characharam. Mountains, rivers, birds, animals, humans, stars, planets, sun, moon, they are all just a few signals created by her which get into your brain through your sensory organs, eyes, ears, skin, nose and tongue, and create this illusion, this virtual reality. See how easy it is. She doesn't have to create the whole real universe, only a few signals. And the same signals, when they reach the sensory organs of another animal, a cat or a dog, they create a different kind of virtual reality in their brain or mind. If you think deeply, you will realize that even the sensory organs, brain and mind, your own sensory organs, brain and mind, are just a few vibrations. Anyway, this is how she creates this Maya, this illusory world. And why does she do this? For her own amusement, entertainment. She creates this illusion with a few signals. The components of this illusory world then start interacting with each other and makes it really complex and complicated. This is what she enjoys watching. She binds and attaches each and every part of this illusion that she has created and makes it more complex and complicated. And she enjoys this fun. If someone gets a hint of what is going on, whom we consider to be a jnani, she pushes them back into this mess, deeper. Jnaninam api chetamsi. Can this ever stop? Yes, if and only if she wants. Only when she wants. She can stop this game for individuals whenever she wants. She can stop this whole game for everyone, altogether, whenever she wants. Which is what we call pralaya. Child takes his toys from the box, plays with them for some time, amuses himself, and puts them back into the box after some time. Creation, sustenance and elimination. This is how it works. During this play, you will see the toys talking to each other, attacking each other, sitting one above the other. Some even get damaged in the process, but it is a game, ultimately. The child can pick up one toy and keep it aside, or put everything back into the box together till the next time he feels like playing. So whether it is one toy or all the toys, it is entirely up to the child. The child is the whole and sole decision maker. It is the same in the case of Mother Goddess also. She only starts the game. She only decides when to stop, be it for an individual or for everyone together. And if she is pleased, she gives mukti. She alone is the ultimate knowledge. She only causes attachment to the world. She alone gives mukti also. And she is the Ishwari of all Ishwaras. Shri Jagadambayai Namaha.
Yajna Hrishre Kadamal Karma.